I'll tell you that the Ghana was the first African country to have set up an embassy in Mexico. Also, Mexico was the first Latin American country that between the 1965 and through to 1980 had an embassy here. It was shut down temporarily, but in 2014 it was reopened. I've been joined by the Deputy Minister for Foreign Affairs for the Republic of Mexico, and he's been a career diplomat since 2006, joining his government on big international engagements for the furtherance of their country's business and economy and development and tourism and climate change and all the issues in between. My guest this morning is Ambassador Ulian Ventura. Chief, good morning. Thank you very much for your time. How are you doing? Welcome to Ghana.
Very well. I'm very excited to be here.
It's very firm handshake.
Thank you very much. No, it's an exciting time for Ghana and for Mexico. We have a good relationship, as you mentioned. We opened an embassy, the first Latin American country to open an embassy in Ghana after Ghanaian independence. We're here since 2014 with a stronger presence, okay. But it's a relationship that can go much farther.
I see. How has Ghana been treating you?
Oh, very well. I've had a wide range of visits. This is the second day of a two-day visit. I met with my counterpart in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs yesterday. We signed the establishment of a new bilateral political consultation group, which is going to enable us to review comprehensively the bilateral agenda. I met with the Vice Minister of Agriculture. We have very good programs which are building up Ghanaian capacities in terms of maize nutritional levels and yields, so it's a very promising avenue. And of course with the business community, because they're the ones that are taking the lead in growing our trade and investment relationship, which has an incredible potential in the short and medium term.
So this would be a reciprocal visit, considering the fact that Speaker of Parliament, GIPC and the rest had visited you earlier. What do you seek to achieve with this visit?
Well, really, first is to affirm the new Mexican government's commitment to continue to grow this very important relationship. Secondly, to try to build a roadmap which results in concrete steps on areas that are of interest to Ghana and of interest to Mexico. We already do a lot of work together, for example, in the United Nations, on development cooperation, on climate change, on all those issues that are important to both our governments and to both our societies. But if you're not here and if you don't jointly agree on a set of actions that you can take, really you can't get anywhere. The Ghanaian economy is growing at one of the highest, fastest rates of growth in the African continent. It's an exciting time in terms of the establishment of the free trade zone, a continental free trade area established by the African Union. And Mexico is a global leader in terms of free trade. We are very well connected to the North American market, to the Asia Pacific market. Now we have to work with Africa. And this is the platform where we can expand our presence at a continental level in a very proactive way.
The launch of the African Free Trade Agreement would ensure that tariffs are brought down in Africa, so a lot more business injection can be made. What's your plan going forward?
The first step is to get our business communities to get to know each other better. We've already had, we had the Minister of Trade visit Mexico in 2017.
Alan Tremonti.
Yes, I'm going to be meeting him later this morning after I meet with the Foreign Minister. We hope to have him back soon, but in any case, a high-level business delegation from Ghana will be in Cancun later this year, in October, for the big investment conference in Mexico. And if we get those business communities together, it's where the relationships are built. So this interest in terms of the market opportunities that are available in Ghana and in Mexico, with the perspective that the free trade continental area is opening, will really enable us to increase our footprint in Africa and to increase Ghana's footprint in Latin America.
Interesting. Let's talk about the private sector, for example, because largely trade will depend on them. Facilitated by government, of course. You have interest in the private sector. What is your exact plan moving forward? We have a lot of people who have business interests, you know, from your end here and vice versa.
The agricultural sector is very promising. We have a Mexican investment in the Volta region, which is a hydroponic development of fresh fruit and vegetables, tomatoes and other products. We're going to be helping expand production in maize and rice in the Volta region. I've seen a lot of interest in the tourism sector. If we can work to increase, for example, air connectivity, we can really make a difference in the tourism market. There's also a lot of opportunities for Mexican companies in the food services sector, in the manufacturing sector. One area in which there is keen interest in Ghana is in the automotive sector. What can we do to increase our value chains in auto parts, in auto production, where you have Mexico being one of the top five automotive production hubs in the world, and Ghana, which is going to very soon be the main production and platform for production and export to the African continent. So those are two areas. I would add aerospace, for example, where if we look at things from a strategic, medium and long-term perspective, we can increase the density of our contacts in a very concrete and specific way.
Right, interesting. You talk about tourism.
Yes.
What about it that intrigues you? For example, this year is the year of return, where the first set of 400 slaves were taken from here 400 years ago to Virginia in the United States. What is it about our tourism that intrigues you, and what do you hope for us to learn from you?
Well, Ghana has incredible natural and historical attributes that can make it one of the top destinations of in the African continent, and especially in West Africa. Mexico received 40 million international visitors last year. That's more than the rest of Latin America combined. We've had experience in developing resorts. We have the second largest number of UNESCO World Heritage sites, which is something that Ghana is developing with a very strategic way to combine history and tourism in an eco-friendly way. So there's know-how, technical cooperation, and commercial opportunities that can stem from that dialogue that we can develop as we go forward.
The question of climate change, of course, the SDGs were mentioned as a big conversation across the world. What are plans to make sure that we are savvy with that and to ensure that we are all safe as a globe in terms of climate change?
Well, Mexico has been a world leader in terms of the climate change negotiations. We hosted the Cancun COP16 summit in 2016, and we made it a point to bring to the table the concerns of the African group in terms of climate change, one of the most vulnerable regions in the world to climate change. And what we have built from there is a close consultation mechanism in which we can move toward the high-level climate change summit that we'll be having in September of this year in New York to make sure that Africa's concerns are on the table. There is no initiative that can prosper in a very difficult international environment without building bridges with African
Is it your opinion that Africa is working assiduously towards achieving climate change? For example, in terms of tree planting, in terms of plastic abuse, in terms of the other things that come.
I mean, of course, it's a large-scale issue and there's a lot of work to be done, but the political commitment is there. And in a world where it's very difficult to build consensus at this time, we have a lot of uncertainty, a tendency toward unilateral measures and abandoning international agreements. Countries like Mexico work together with Ghana to make sure that our concerns as major economies, as developing economies, are at the table and are reflected in the international agreements, those agreements are going to be sustainable in the future. So we are working very actively together to make sure that the climate change agenda is top of mind and its links with the development cooperation agenda as well in the 2030 goals of the United Nations, where there will also be an international summit in September in New York.
If there's a local businessman watching now and he feels intrigued about your plans for business and for development, how can they, for example, tap into this? Do they come to you? Do they go to government? Where do they go?
Well, the first stop is always the Mexican embassy in Accra. They have all the tools, all the resources to be able to present the opportunities that are there in Mexico and to help build agendas. I will be meeting the foreign minister later on this morning, and Ghana is moving rapidly toward the establishment of an embassy in Mexico, and that will also be a key element to support our business communities. And the second stage will be, of course, to go to Mexico and to meet the Mexican business community. We're the world's 15th largest economy. We're integrated into the North American and Latin American markets. We're a G20 country, and there's great opportunities for investment and for building capacities as Ghana develop its economic footprint in the African continent.
Let's stay within the G20, the 15 most flourishing economies, and ask, for example, about the conversation about you being a stronger economy and most of the economies in Africa not being too strong. How are we looking at the fair playing ground, a unique partnership?
Well, it's very important because one of the assets of the G20 is that you have major emerging economies with the world's developed economies. And what we have said is that you can't have sustainable agreements that foster an open economy, an economic environment that is rules-based at the international level, without taking everybody's positions into account. Okay. So with the consolidation of African-led initiatives toward economic reform and economic integration, the African voice will be stronger as we move forward in the G20. So we're very much we're very excited about the possibilities of making sure that the initiatives that are taking place here really build up Africa's presence as a responsible member of the international
community. Timelines for this?
Well, it's impressive how fast the ratification process went in Africa. I know there was a high-level meeting this week here on the free trade continental area. So I don't think it'll be very long before we start seeing those results reflected in the Ghanaian economy and in the African continent as a whole.
Amazala, thank you very much for
Thank you very much.
Donald Trump said he was going to build the wall over Mexico and you're going to pay.
Yes.
Have you paid for the wall?
Not at all. We've been very clear that we will not pay for any physical structures between one of the most promising and competitive economic zones in the world. We work together with our American friends and neighbors on a wide range of issues. We're the world's largest economic bloc. The U.S. has a sovereign right to do what it feels in its territory, but we're focused on increasing the prosperity and productivity of the North American market.
Thank you. That's Ambassador Julian Ventura. He's the Deputy Foreign Affairs Minister for the Republic of Mexico. And he says that we will make progress together, working hand in glove. Let's